Now, KSPW Weather with Jim VanderZwan.
So far, so good. As we get through spring, starting to get the hints of summer, a little bit of that fog right there, a couple of patches this morning. Didn't take long to clear it off, though. It's still hovering just offshore, and we still have a low marine inversion layer, so we're bound to get a little bit of it back. Overnight lows, though, about normal, 40s, highs in the 70s. A little cooler in Watsonville today with a 65. Match that up in Marina, 62, Seaside, Monterey, another 65 in PG, and 69 in Carmel Valley. So pretty pleasant weather there, and breezes weren't too strong. 67 in Salinas, then back up to 75 by the time you get to King City. We match that in Morgan Hill and Gilroy. A little cooler in San Jose and Hollister, but no complaints. Nice weather. Warmest stuff, of course, out in the Central Valley, 73 Sacramento. For the rest, hovering around 80 degrees, give or take a few. Mostly 70 still in Southern California, with the exception of the desert. And it's very pleasant over the west, because we've got high pressure at 71 today in Seattle and Boise, 86 in Phoenix. Mile High City doing all right. Chicago's still kind of cool, though, 51, but just barely, 64 St. Louis, 67 in New York, and the Gulf Coast mild enough with 70s. Haven't gotten the real hot, muggy stuff just as well. Got an upper-level low right here, a little snow in the upper parts of the Great Lakes. For the rest, it's rain and thunderstorms. A little wind damage here and there, a couple of hailstones, but no severe weather. Nothing that caused any major problems. Likewise, with the storms coming off the front range of the Rockies, so for now, it's kind of quiet. This upper-level low-pressure trough will keep things cool on the East Coast, but no major weather. We'll probably get some thunder boomers in the afternoon tomorrow, though, in the Plain States, and they're looking for the rain, and likely not all that severe. High pressure, the dominant feature out west, with the storm track staying north, and that'll likely continue for a while. Everything coming out of the Pacific, going on up into Canada, over the top of this dry air, and that's the high-pressure ridge. Little low-pressure system that went by yesterday is moving on out. 5,000-foot temperatures indicate over the next 4 or 5 days the air mass gets progressively warmer. We'll go with that north and northeasterly flow in the upper levels of the atmosphere, and then we start getting some hot air moving into the south. Sunday will likely be the peak, and then it begins to cool off a little bit, but we don't have a strong offshore flow on the surface to go along with this. Cooler air aloft will come by as the storm tracks the north to bring things back down to normal. So it's just a mini, mini heat wave, but not even all that strong. We'll keep with a little bit of fog and low clouds, keep that sea breeze in the afternoon. Probably keep a little bit of fog around Saturday morning. Probably less on Sunday, so it's still looking pretty good with not a lot of strong wind for the Big Sur Marathon either, which is also good news. Figure about 59, though, in San Francisco. Might get some low 70s in the South Bay. Mid to upper 70s ought to do it tomorrow as we get a little bit of that cool air coming in. So still nice, but these are comfortable temperatures. Not too hot, not too cold. Might see a few mid-80s at the south end of the Salinas Valley. And around the peninsula, upper 50s to mid-60s ought to do the trick for another day. And overnight lows, 40s and 50s, likely will be for a while. 69 Watsonville will figure 70s from Santa Cruz all the way up into the mountains there. Pretty much clear, fog and low clouds inland overnight. And we'll go with light winds, kind of variable. Picking up in the afternoon to about 20 miles an hour, and after some morning low clouds and a little bit of local drizzle possible along the coast, not a lot of it to go around, and it looks like we've got a good bet for sunshine for most, and ditto for Saturday after, again, that morning stratus, but it looks like it's not hanging around like it often does in the summer. And we'll figure it warms up, and we're going to get 80s and 90s by Sunday for the Santa Cruz Mountains and most of the valleys, with the exception of Salinas, so that from about Chular south it gets pretty hot. Then begins to cool down back to normal by the middle of next week. And along the coast and into the north end of Salinas Valley, well, 60s and 70s, which is about right. A little bit of fog in the morning isn't going to bother anybody for too long, and we'll go for a little less of it Tuesday, Wednesday. So nice place to park for a while, and it's not going to rain, looks like, for a
while. Nice stuff.
Yep. And, yeah, great weather for the marathon, although I think you mentioned at 5, it could even get a little warm.
Yeah, for the slower runners, they're going to pay the price for, you know, getting in the mid to upper 60s, which doesn't sound warm to most of us if you're sitting there watching it. But if you're doing this, it's warm. So
Dan and I wouldn't know anything about that slower runner
They called me the panter.
The last horse in the barn, you know.